more detailing to the head. Okay. So I have this kind of hairstyle, so I'll make that right now. Okay, so we give a point here for her parting, and I draw a curvy line like this, and then another one like that, and some scallops for her hair, and then give some more scallops here, and then we'll just join it to the top of the head like this. You don't have to make the same hairstyle. Yeah, you're free to give her whatever hairstyle you think you would like to see in your on your vat. Whiskers. Oh yes, whiskers. Important bit. There you go. Okay. What next? Let's give her a mask, which is very important right now. Just draw a slanting line, a curvy line like this, and then another one like this. So this is done. Now the eyes, circle, circle, and the eyeballs. Oops. Okay. Now this eyebrow is showing, so let's draw this. The other one is hiding under the hair. So this is done. Now let's give her a little neck. Just two little lines like this, and then a curvy line for her top. And now we are going to add the detailing for the doctor's coat that she's wearing. For that, let's give a dot here. So this is where it's going to end, a dot here, and now we have to merge it to the sides of the neck, so, like this. Hello. And now we start from here and go this wide on both sides, and then draw V shapes like this. And then we'll erase this little part here, so it looks like doctor's coat. Now from here we have to come down like this, and then you can add buttons. Okay. So this is done. Now we are going to go over it with a pen. So I'm using this fiber tip marker. I have to make sure that this is permanent ink. Yeah, this is waterproof, because I'm going to use water after I color it. So I start with the hair. Nose, maybe a little bit is showing like this, and the coat. Can you draw a cat with a mask, please? Oh, I think I'll just leave the cat like this because it's so tiny. Yeah, I won't. That'll be like too much detail. I'll just leave the cat, this one, without the mouth. Or maybe I'll try because it's a cute idea. Okay. So draw a little bit of net. I think I'll just leave the mark because then I won't be able to show the whiskers and the face, which won't be very nice. Okay, this is done. Now the leg. This is done. Now I'm going to erase the pencil marks. I forgot the cat's eye. Okay, let's color this up. I think I'll use my watercolor. I'll use both watercolors and pencil colors. I think I'll start with the pencil colors and then I'll make a few bits with the watercolor. Her hands and wherever the skin is showing. And I'll do the hair with watercolor. So I'm taking the I'm taking a thin brush, it's the number one, and I'm going to give her brown hair. So I'm swirling the brush over my pan, color pan, and then I'm going over the hair. I'm going to give her blue apron. So I'm cleaning my brush and taking some light blue color. Is it, I think it's usually. Is there a specific color for the wet? I think it's greenish blue. But I'm going to use this blue for now. Low, okay. So which colors are you using? What medium? Are you also using watercolors? Or the paints? Okay. Now the trousers. So I am going to give her purple trousers. Okay, you're not coloring right now. Are you going to color later? Fire engine, yes, sure. Yeah, that's a good idea actually. We can do that next Thursday. Yeah, next I'll put it on my list and draw next. Fire engine next Thursday. Okay. So yeah, I think I'll do rest of it with color pencils. I'm going to color the collars with this, my watercolor pencil, and then the cat's carrier can be pink. In the center of the cat carrier, I'm just giving the same pink but with more pressure, so it looks like it's inside and a little bit darker. And for the cat, orangish color. Another the handle. Black. And her mark can be polka dot. Let's get a blue polka dot with the felt pen. And her shoes, her shoes can be black. So her shoes are looking a bit like slippers. I will draw a tiny heel so they don't look like slippers. Alright, so this is done. Now let's go over the pencil color with a little water. After finishing this live session, I have my sketchbook club. I'll give you a little sneak peek of what we are going to draw today in the club in the end. Okay, this is done. Little bit of touch over the inside. And now a little bit of ground for her to stand on. So I'll just take lots of water. And can the cat be black and white? Yeah, you can color your cat in black and white. I've already done mine. Sorry, I didn't see this comment. Sometimes I get too focused in what I'm doing and I forget to read the comments. So yeah, so I'm taking lots of water and taking a little bit of gray color, and first I'll test how it looks, how much pigment I have. So this is like too much, so I'll just use up a little bit, have some more water, and then I'll touch it up like this. So she has somewhere to stand on, so this is, gives an impression of a floor. Okay, oh, see how my orange of the cat got here, which is a mistake, but I don't mind mistakes. Mistakes are okay. That's looking, still looking good, isn't it? So there you are. This is all finished. Hope you enjoyed the lesson. And before I go, I will show you what we are drawing in the sketchbook club. Ta-da! So this is what we are doing. We are learning about. This is the thing that we're going to draw in the sketchbook club. We're learning about urban sketching, that is what we draw when we are traveling. So this is Willemstad in Curacao, right? Okay, so with that, I end my session and I'll see you tomorrow. Thank you so much for joining me, and hope you enjoyed drawing the web. And I can't wait to see your drawing. Please don't forget to send it to me, or if you post it on social media, tag me.